Hey guys, what's up? I'm Brianna. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much if you are coming back and you're a subscriber. And if you're not subscribed, make sure that you go ahead and click the subscribe button. Welcome to my channel. So guys, today I'm going to be talking about relaxed hair habits that you should have. There's good habits and there's bad habits, but today we're going to talk about good habits. So if you're interested in knowing, then just keep on watching. So guys, one of the habits that I have in my healthy, relaxed hair journey is wrapping my hair up at night. I will literally wake up out of my sleep and get my scarf and my bonnet, my silk scarf and my bonnet, and put that on. Like, it's so funny because it's just like, you know how you fall asleep with like clothes on or something like that? Like, that's kind of like me without my scarf on. Like, I know I have to get up. I know I have to get up and put that scarf on, but usually I put it on before I fall asleep. It only happens like when I'm super, super sleepy, and then, you know, I'll wake up in the middle of the night and hurry up and put it on. But that is definitely one of my healthy, relaxed hair habits that I have that's just instilled in me. I think my mom probably instilled that in me, like, wrap your hair up. My mom and my grandma. Another healthy hair habit that I have is sealing and moisturizing. So whether I'm in protective styles or even if my hair is out, unless it's straightened, I'm always moisturizing and sealing. It's just something about my hair that, you know, it itches, of course, when your scalp is dry. And also, I just feel the need to do it. Like, I have my oils and stuff on my counter so that I can see them. And I really feel like it's out of mind, out of sight. So if you can see it, then you remember. So I have my Atara hair oil sitting right on my counter. The bottle and the packaging is so beautiful. It just blends right in. And I just go ahead and put that on my scalp every single night, or I try when I remember to every single night, and that is definitely a habit that I have. So a habit that I should have but I definitely don't have is deep conditioning. Like, I definitely feel like I need to deep condition way, way more, but the only thing with that is I don't wash my hair that much. So when I'm in protective styles, I'm in protective styles, you know, a month, 2 months, and during that time I'm not taking my braids down because it takes forever to braid my hair, and I just really hate the process. So once my hair is braided, it's like it's a done deal. They're not coming out. So if you're someone who doesn't really protect a style in wigs and stuff like that, and it's still easier for you to get to your hair in deep condition, I would definitely recommend that. I need to work on that definitely, but my life is also so busy where I just don't have time. And as you guys can see right now, I am in a custom Wig Fall Styles unit, and I'll be rocking my hair like this for one more week, and then after that I'm gonna get my hair together. Another healthy hair habit that I have is trimming my ends. So every 4 months I get a relaxer, I trim my ends. But anytime in between that, if I see that I need to dust up or get my ends trimmed, I'm on it. Like, I do not sleep on trims. Some people are afraid to get trims, but not me. Like, I'm not afraid, I'm not mad at it. If it needs to be cut, cut it. Another healthy hair habit that I have is feeling my hair and seeing if it has a moisture overload or a protein overload. I've never had those things happen, but I can definitely tell when I need to add protein or moisture inside of my hair, and I make sure that I do so. Usually when I'm in braids, I am putting that moisture into my braids and also sealing it with the oil. So I'm really good with moisture, and I also sometimes spray some water on my hair. So I think I've already told you guys that water is like the ultimate moisturizer. So sometimes I will spray my hair with water as well, but you should definitely get to know your hair, learn the ins and outs of your hair, know when your hair needs protein, know when it needs moisturizer, and really get familiar with your hair. Like, that's the best thing that you can do through a hair journey. Some things may change and you may be totally lost and not know what to do, but usually when you have healthy hair habits, you will notice when something's off about your hair. So guys, if you have any questions, leave them down below. I hope that you have some healthy hair habits. If so, leave them down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.